An underrated but very powerful feature inside of SmartSuite is the ability to assign teams inside of your organization. When you create a team in SmartSuite, you make it so that when you add new members to that team in the future, they are automatically given the same level of permission that you determine for members of the team, which means that they can see stuff that's specific for that team, and it makes it easier for your onboarding as you grow your team. In this video, I'm gonna be breaking down everything you need to know about leveraging SmartSuite's teams. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth. I'm the owner here at Gap Consulting, and it's our mission to help you get organized and automated with no-code tools. SmartSuite's one of our favorite no-code tools. It is incredibly powerful. The things you can build and share across different departments inside of your organization. And in this video, as I mentioned, we're gonna be diving into how you can leverage different teams within your organization. It's gonna allow you to have faster onboarding. As you add new team members, they will get instant access to the things they need in SmartSuite. But before we get started, I wanna first invite you to check out some automation training. If you're new to no-code tools in general, or maybe you just need a refresher course, my free automation training is gonna give you all the building blocks you need so that you can start leveraging automation inside of no-code. It's gonna teach you, regardless of what system you're using, how to build no-code automation to start saving you massive amounts of time. So grab that training at gapconsulting.io/webinar-registration. And wherever you found this video, we will include links that will take you right there. But without further ado, let's hop on into my screen and we're gonna start looking at teams. Now the core takeaway here, the first thing we need to make sure of is that we have workspace administrator privileges. If we don't have that high level of permission inside of our organization in SmartSuite, then we can't do any of this stuff. So we're gonna go ahead and click up here. And if you do not see workspace administration, you don't have the permission level required. You might wanna reach out to other folks on your team to make sure that you can get this access. But if you have this access, let's go ahead and click it, and it's gonna take us to the part where we can look at all the different workspace settings. Now, by default, it's taking us right here, and this is the loading page, if you will, the dashboard for your workspace settings. But what I wanna take our attention to is actually the second and third tabs here. Managing members, this is where we can access the different members inside of our organization that have access to our workspace. So if you ever need to remove somebody because they left the organization, then you can do that right here. Simply find that person and say delete member. But specifically, we also want to drill into, for our use case anyway, the managed teams, the third tab over here. And right now, I don't have any teams in my demo account, so I'm going to set one up. Now, the nice thing about teams in SmartSuite is it's incredibly flexible, so you can fill out whatever teams you have. Let's say we had a relatively sizable organization and we had a team called sales. First, I just fill out the name of the team and then I can select what color is going to represent them. Sales looks like a nice blue, and whether this is an active or an inactive team. And now I can also add members from my SmartSuite account over to the team. So who's on this team? And you know, I could just pick folks at random here for the sake of our example and create this team. Now I've got this team that I can manage simply from this dashboard here. Now again, the names of these teams is entirely flexible. So if you have finance, you could go ahead and create that. If you call it something different in your organization, accounting and finance, or finance and accounting, or whatever it is, go plug in whatever name you have, make sure it's active, and add the different members onto this particular team and create the team. Now we have the ability to go in and of course edit that team further. So once we have it all listed up and created, we can drill back in here, and this is where we can access the different members, add new folks as they come on, remove them if somebody gets moved to a different team, etc. So you have full flexibility here in terms of managing that team and making sure that it's an accurate representation of what's happening inside of your organization. Now, this in and of itself may not be that exciting, but It gets really impressive when we get to the next level. So let's actually close down our workspace settings and go back to my workspace and imagine that we had different solutions inside of our organization that were specific to different teams. Let's say project tracking is one such solution, and inside of this particular project tracking solution, we want to make sure that any new person who's added to our finance team has access right to the solution. So rather than going in one at a time inside of the solution permissions and adding these members one at a time, that would be quite painful. So let's avoid that, and instead we're going to add access to a specific team. So I can come out and X out who has access to this, and we're going to say just finance. Just finance in this case is going to have access to this information. And once we're happy with that, close this on down. Now, the key takeaway here is that as we add new members to the finance team, then they are going to automatically get access to this database. This solution, because we've granted access for the finance team, is going to see just that. Now, similarly, I can do this at the application level as well. If you don't already know, this is one of the key features of SmartSuite, the fact that we have such granular permissions. Now, right here, we're inheriting from solution, meaning the solution permissions that we applied at the solution level are also impacting this particular application. But maybe we have a solution that has five different applications, and one or two of those applications is the stuff that needs to be visible by the sales team, and the rest of it needs to be available to finance. Well, here's where we come in and we can change that. So we can say that you have access to the solution, as we've already done for the finance team, but we can get more granular at the application level. So we can override the solution permissions, and here's where we can add teams or members. So note that yes, I can always go in and manually add people, but I can also access the different teams who've been granted access to the solution. So in this case, the finance team has been granted access to the solution, so I can add them right here and determine what kind of access they have. This is really cool as well, because maybe from one application to the next within my organization, I don't want people to have the same permissions. Maybe I've got five different applications and finance can see all of them, but here for this project's application, I want to make them contributors. Maybe for the next application, I want to make them commenters. So I can change up the level of permission they have at the application level based on the team with just a few clicks of a button when I'm setting this all up. So let's go ahead and add full access here to our finance team. But if I come back into my solution and I again go to my permissions, I could add another team, let's say sales here. So now sales and finance both have access to the overall solution. And just for the sake of our demonstration here, I can drill back into projects permissions. Let's find them. And right here, you'll see that only finance can see the project's application. So this is kind of a silly example because sales has access to a solution, but nothing inside of the solution. But the takeaway from this is that you have the granular level of permissions at an application level. And in fact, even deeper than that, you can go as narrowly as the field level inside of an application. If I wanted to say maybe just this field, I can even do permissions at this level and edit who can have access here. The reason that this is so powerful is because as your organization grows, you will onboard new people to your SmartSuite workspace. And when you add new people, simply coming on down to workspace administration, and you add a new member, let's come on over to members, and we can bring in somebody new, and I'll just use example at example.com. Yes, we can say you have a specific role within the organization. Yes, we can say this is your member type, but most importantly for our example here, we can also assign you to a team when we add you to SmartSuite. So that gives you instant access to all of the different applications and solutions that have already been granted to the team you are now assigned to. Also note that you can belong to multiple teams, granting you even more flexibility when you onboard new folks. I know we went pretty fast in this video, but there is a lot to unpack in terms of how teams and permissions work inside of SmartSuite. So drop any questions that we did not answer below wherever you found the video. And in the meantime, keep on building.